Good afternoon, all the juries, all the listeners. I am going to present the topic, which is named Maximum Cranial Breadth in Sexing of Crania with the Medico-Legal Importance. Myself, Dr. Ruta Bapat, Associate Professor in Dr. D. Y. Patil Medical College, Nehru. Next. Coming with the introduction, the sexing is a common and critical problem in identifying the deceased person from the bones. The record of organic evolution is largely written by the hard parts of the body, that is bones. Hence, the skeleton remains have been used for sexing of the individual in almost all the bones of the human skeleton, showing some degree of sexual dimorphism. This is about the introduction. The cranial measurements, which give the simplest and fairly accurate way of judging the similarity or the differences when comparing the skulls from different racial groups. The correct sex determination is a critical requirement in physical anthropology and medico-legal cases. Next, please. Aim and objective of the present study: to study the sexual dimorphism in adult human crania by using the two parameters. One is the maximum cranial breadth linear and the other parameter is maximum cranial breadth curved. Next, please. Material and methods. Total 310 adult human crania of known sex as a male or female were studied for the present study. Only fully ossified adult crania were included in the present study. Crania showing wear and tear, any fracture or pathology were excluded. The measurements means which used were spreading caliper, scale, thread, chalk and marker. Next. These are the measurements means which were used in the present study. Next. Coming to what is the option, after checking all the parameters, the range, mean, standard deviation of these measurements were calculated. The identification point for each parameter was taken out from the range. Demarking points were worked out from the calculated range. And finally, the difference observed between the means of male and female to know whether it is statistically significant, that is the value of P, was calculated by applying Z-test. Next, please. Coming towards the metrical parameters which were taken, the maximum cranial breadth linear, which have taken at the right angle to the mid-sagittal plane, it was taken at the level of midpoint of the supramastoid crest with the help of spreading caliper, while the maximum cranial breadth curve have been taken with the same points with the help of thread. Next. Now this is the observation table which is showing for the maximum cranial breadth linear, where you can see the observation table in that the number of bones which have given 155 male, 155 female, range have been calculated. The mean, all the values have been taken in the centimeter, standard deviation, then there is an identification point, percentage of identified bones, calculated range, demarking point was calculated, and finally it has been concluded that the sex difference in the mean values of maximum cranial breadth linear of male and in female crania is statistically highly significant. Next, please. Yes. So this, you can see, this is the maximum cranial breadth, which have been studied in the present study, and it has been compared with all the other scientists too. So this is about the maximum cranial breadth linear. Next, please. This is the maximum cranial breadth curve, There again, the same observation table has been prepared. And again, the number of bones, range, mean, standard deviation, identification point, percentage of identified bones, calculated range, and demarking points were calculated. Again, the sex difference in mean values of the maximum cranial breadth curve of crania is statistically highly significant. Next, please. So here we have compared the linear breadth with that of the curved breadth, where you can see the difference in case of male and female crania. So when we see about the maximum cranial breadth linear and maximum cranial breadth, we can see there is a difference is there in the curved lengths because of the variation in the vault of the crania, which give the variable results in the curved breadth. Next, please. So actually, all the studies have been taken with that of the linear breadth, but in our study, only we have taken the curved breadth because in this method, the curvature of the cranial vault is considered. So that's why we have taken specifically the curved breadth, which is the new study which we have been taking. Next, please. Coming towards the summary and conclusion, the 155 male and 155 female crania were studied. Metrical data of cranial breadth, linear and curved were collected. The univariate statistical tests were applied to the metrical data. The sex overlap is observed in both the parameters, as it is always sex overlap is there. And finally, it has been concluded that the maximum cranial breadth, which is found to be the best discriminating parameter in sexing of crania. I have all the references. And lastly, thank you so much for listening.